traffic counting made easier and simpler, with faster turnaround and better coverage. Fill data gaps with traffic counts for nearly every roadway segment, from main arterials to local roads. Save time without putting staff in harm's way or relying on outdated equipment. Reduce data checks with defensible traffic counts, saving time and money. There are currently more than 200,000 public at-grade railroad crossings in the United States. The Federal Rail Crossing Elimination Grant Program has allocated $2.5 billion over the next 5 years to remove dangerous at-grade railroad crossings and improve safety throughout. To develop an exposure model that will prioritize crash hotspots needing improvements, agencies first need to understand roadway AEDT at these crossings, such as the one I'm showing here. Since many of these locations are rural, a big data approach can reduce labor-intensive data collection. In this example, 2022 AEDT was processed for over 1,300 at-grade railroad crossings in the state of Montana. Specifically, we have analyzed a series of railroad crossings along the I-94 corridor southwest of Billings. In the platform, you can visualize the AEDT counts for these crossing segments, which range from nearly 15,000 vehicles per day in downtown Billings to less than 100 vehicles per day in some of the more rural locations. StreetLight AEDT can be used to develop crash rates for your agency to help your staff better identify where safety improvements are needed most urgently. The Fern Hollow Bridge carries nearly 15,000 vehicles per day on Forbes Avenue across a large ravine in Frick Park in Pittsburgh, PA. In January 2022, this bridge collapsed and was closed to traffic until a replacement bridge was constructed and eventually opened in late December. With StreetLight AEDT, we can measure the impacts of the bridge closure in 2022 on parallel roadways. The analyzed roads were selected from StreetLight's zone library of open street map segments. Bidirectional AEDT was then processed at each of these six locations for the calendar years 2019 through 2022. These metrics were then downloaded from the StreetLight InSight platform in a CSV file format and exported into a spreadsheet for analysis. Significant increases in traffic volume were observed in 2022 for Hamilton Avenue and Penn Avenue to the north of Fern Hollow Bridge, as well as I-376 and Ford Avenue to the south. However, the total number of east-west daily trips was less than the 2021 average, suggesting that demand for trip making in this region dropped with the important connection closed. So with just a few clicks, users can run year-over-year time trend analyses with StreetLight AEDT to measure impacts of construction closures, as well as new infrastructure, policies, or changing traveler behaviors, such as hybrid and work-from-home trends resulting from the COVID-19 pandemic.